A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 5th March, on the front page you have Pakistan bans UN Security Council designated outfits. Delhi not convinced. So, two Lashkar-e-Toiba offshoots, which have been named designated as terrorist organizations by UN Security Council, have been banned by Pakistan. So, there is intense international pressure on Pakistan. We have seen how the Financial Action Task Force has also continued to keep Pakistan on grey list and has warned that it may be blacklisted too. So it would affect its financial standing and deal relations in international scenario. So that is why Pakistan is seen now acting against two Lashkar-e-Taiba offshoots, that is Jamaat-ul-Dawah and Fateh-e-Insaniyat Foundation. But then New Delhi, or rather India, is skeptical about the move, because Pakistan's attempts to ban these groups in the past was only to drop the ban after some time. Then below you have, we hit target in Balakot, didn't count casualties. So this is the Indian Air Force Chief, Air Chief Marshal B.S. Dhona, who is saying to the media that there are questions on the number of casualties in Balakot airstrike. So this is his response to that. And this is, hold simultaneous Lok Sabha Assembly elections. Jammu and Kashmir parties urge Election Commission. So Election Commission in Jammu and Kashmir has been asked to hold simultaneous elections. So it would get first-hand information on the ground situation now. Because Lok Sabha elections are due and Jammu and Kashmir is under President's rule. So Assembly elections are due here too. So that is why this demand is being made. On page 6, you have Manipur considering ST status for Metis. So Manipur Chief Minister N. Biren Singh has told the assembly that BJP-led coalition government of Manipur will give positive consideration to the demand for inclusion of Metis, which is a non-tribal indigenous community. So it will be included in the scheduled tribes list. Then on page 7, you have crop burning raises risk of respiratory illness threefold, says IFPRI study. So this is a study which says that living near 100 fires a day is a leading risk factor for acute respiratory illness. It outweighs factors like cracker burning in Diwali or high motor vehicle congestion too. So stubble burning is a cause of huge concern according to this study which has been undertaken. So it increases risks of respiratory illness threefold. Then below you have India to tie up with four nations to save rhinos. So recently we have seen regarding rhino population, there was a meet held on Asian rhinos in New Delhi too. The New Delhi Declaration of Asian Rhinos 2019 has also been signed by these five rhino range nations, that is Nepal, Bhutan, India, Indonesia and Malaysia. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Party and Symbol. So this is regarding AIADMK of Tamil Nadu, the political party to which Jayalalitha belonged. She was the leader of the party, but after her death, there have been two factions and they've been fighting over the symbol for the party. The symbol is two leaves. So, Election Commission had in its order in November 2017 conferred this symbol on one of the factions of AIADMK, to which the present Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Edappidi Palaniswamy, and Deputy CMO Paneerselvam belong. So, that faction was given the symbol. And now this verdict of and now the order of Election Commission has been upheld in this Delhi High Court verdict. So, this is regarding that. And the second editorial, alarming spread. So this is regarding H1N1 flu, seasonal flu strain, the virus. It is said that now this strain as such, which has developed as a seasonal strain now, care workers and others are at risk and they must be vaccinated. So that is highlighted because those who take care of patients, like nurses or others too, so they are at risk from H1N1 and they must be vaccinated, is what this editorial argues for. And then the lead article is the language of Pakistan. So this talks of how India must guard against the type of politics that shaped and continues to ruin Pakistan. So in short, it is about lessons we must learn from Pakistan. And this is a pivotal election in Thailand. So this is again regarding Thailand politics. You can see there, you know, the system is such that the military is at an advantage even in democracy. So, but then Thaksin Shinawatra is a popular leader who was not contesting elections, what his political party and his associates are. So this is regarding that. You can skip it too. Then this is an article on solar powerhouse regarding residential consumers seeing rooftop solar is a viable electricity option. So now building awareness about this is crucial, is what is argued for. On page 10 you have, will work to ease tensions, says China. So China says that even it is backing Russian proposal to use Shanghai Cooperation Organization SCO, in which both India and Pakistan are members along with China and Russia. So Shanghai Cooperation Protocols may be used to resolve the issue between India and China. On international page you have China US close to reaching trade deal. So there has been a trade war going on between US and China specifically, and it's a global trade war. So now they are having a trade deal finalized. So this pact would require China to make big purchases from American agriculture and good industry goods as such. So this is one of the key factors here. We have seen USA has a huge trade deficit with China, so to cover that up, steps would be taken. And below you have US downgrades Palestinian mission. So the US has downgraded its diplomatic mission to Palestinians. So this is the latest in the series of steps taken by President Donald Trump to undermine the Palestinian cause. So we have seen earlier USA has announced Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, though it is a city which is claimed by both Israel and Palestine. On business page you have center to incentivize work from home jobs. So government is working on a scheme to offer financial support to both employers and employees in IT and IT enabled services sector. And this is pharma sector growth hits 4-year low in financial year 2018. So this is regarding pharmaceutical industry. So the performance in the last 5 years is shown here. You can see the percentage increase in turnover. So that has been declining. It's significantly low in 2017-18. And pharma industry blames it on GST and demonetization. Here you have 7 banks fined for delayed SWIFT implementation. So the RBI has imposed a penalty on 7 banks. So these penalties range from rupees 1 crore to rupees 4 crore. So this is for violation of SWIFT. So SWIFT is actually a global messaging software used for transaction by financial entities. So SWIFT implementation has been delayed by some banks. So that is why this fine has been imposed by RBI. And then there's no news coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines from the Hindu newspaper. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. In the current affairs section here, you can download the PDFs, the daily current affairs PDFs too. You can have the monthly compilations downloaded here too. Even for the month of Feb, it will be uploaded in a day or two. And also you can enroll for our course, the current affairs detailed video course. So the details of this and sample video are provided here. So that is it. Thank you.